Hello, this is Sally from Sally Cosmos. In this video, we'll see how to convert arrays into list. So actually, there are three ways of doing this. The first way is by using the asList static method of the arrays class. We'll also see two important characteristics of the return list. One is the fixed size nature of the return list, and the second one is the write through nature. The second way is using the list constructor, and the third way is using the collections API. So let me move to Eclipse and show you one by one. Okay, so here you can see I'm in the main method of the ArrayToList class, and I have defined the names string array and initialized with the three names Sally, Linda, and Priyanka. And I want to convert this names array into a names list. Okay, right now I have initialized it to null, and this statement just prints out the names list. Okay, so if I execute this, it will print nothing. Okay, so let me use the first method of converting the arrays into list. So arrays.asList. This method takes array as an argument and converts them into a list. So as you can see, I have passed the names array to the asList method of the arrays class, and it converts this array into a list, or it returns me a list, names list. Now if I execute this program, you can see that I have a list with these three names, Sally, Linda, and Priyanka. That's great. But one of the important things that you should remember is the return list from this arrays as list method is of fixed size. The first characteristic which I want to show you that is the fixed size nature of the returned list. What I mean by fixed size is, that if you try to change the size of this list, it will give you an exception. So you can change the size of the list only by, you know, adding or removing some element. So let me try to add some element into this list. So let me add name John to it. Now if you try to execute it, you will see that you will get an exception called java.lang.unsupported operation exception. So this is something that you should keep in mind, that if you use arrays.asList method of converting arrays into a list, you cannot add anything to it. The return list is of fixed size. Similarly, you cannot remove also. So if I try to remove something from it, say the index element at the index 0, and execute it, you'll get the same exception here. So this is the first characteristic that you should keep in mind if you use this arrays.asList method for conversion. The second characteristics which I want to show you is the write through property. So what does this mean is, if you try to change anything in the names list, it would be reflected in the names also. Similarly, if you try to change something into the names array, it would be reflected into the names list. So let me show you that. So let us try to change names list. Let me change the element at the index 0 with the name Sally Cosmos. All right. And let me try it. Let me copy this statement and print it before changing. And let me print after changing. So if we execute this program, you will see that when I converted this names array into a names list, it was Sally, Linda, and Priyanka. And when I changed the index element at the 0th index from Sally to Sally Cosmos, this is being changed. That's fine. This is the normal behavior of the how the list works, right? But the important thing which I want to show you is that what if I want to print names array 0 element? What it would be? It feels like it should be a Sally because I have not changed anything into the names array, but it is not. It's not so. If you execute this program, you will see that the name inside the array is also being changed. This is called the write through property. Similarly, if I change the array, say I change names 1 to say John again, right? And if I try to print names list, this one, which I have, this name list is being made from the names array only. So if I execute this program, you will see that this element is being changed to list also. So essentially, RightThrough property says that if you try to change something into the names list, the list which is you made from the this array, the changes would be reflected to the array also. Similarly, if you make any changes to the array, it would be reflected into the list. This is called the RightThrough property of the return list. So remember two things. First thing is that this is a fixed size list. You cannot change the size of this list. If you try to add or remove any element from this list, you will get an exception called unsupported operation exception. Similarly, if you make any changes to this list of the existing elements, that changes would also be reflected into the array. Similarly, if you try changes anything into the array, the changes would be reflected into the names list. Essentially, what does it mean is that both names and names list, now they are pointing to the same data. So if you change it through the names or the names list, other would also be the reflection should also be take place in the other. Okay, so now let me show you the second way of converting the array into a list, right? So let me remove this. And the second way is by using the constructor. Let me say I want to convert arrays into array list, right? So array list takes the list as an argument, as a constructor argument. So you have already know how you can convert the arrays into a list. You can show use the same method, arrays dot as list, and you can pass the names array. Now this is the second way how you can convert the names array into a names list. If I try to print out this names list and let me execute this, and you'll see that Sally, Linda and Priyanka being printed. Now remember this, that this names list, you can do all kind of operations that you can do on a list also. This is not fixed size and this is not right through. Okay, you made a new array list and you passed a list as an argument to this array list, and this array list is being formed from the list which is being returned by this method, right? The third way which you want to use, so essentially if you want to do some kind of operations after you convert the array into an array list, use this method. But if you just want to print or you just want to pass the array into a method which takes list as an argument, you can use the previous method arrays.asList, right? So the third way which I will show you is belongs to the collections API. So let me first define list of string, say names list again, and array list, and you can optionally define the size also here. Okay, so I just defined the array list with the size that is equal to the names array. Now what you can do is you can use the collections dot add all method. The first parameter of this method takes the collection, that is the names list in our case, and the second method takes the elements which you want to add to this collection, to the names list. So I want to add names into it, right? So what this add all method of the collections API would do is it will take the names array, fetch the elements and put into the names list. That's it. The method also says this add all, right? It's very easy. So let me print out this and see. And let me execute now. And you will see this is being done. One of the other use of this collection.add all method is suppose you want to add some elements to this list, right? So let me say, what I mean to say is that suppose you have a names list and let me initialize it to Sally, Linda and Priyanka by using the arrays.asList method, which I shown you previously, names, right? So suppose I want to add more names into it. So you can do this by, and let me have another array, right? String array, new names is equal to new string, and let me define new name called John, Eliana. So now what this add all method of collections API would do is it will take the let me define new names over here. It will take the new names, fetch the new names and add it to this list. So the resulting list would be Sally, Linda, Priyanka and John, Eliana. So this could be the other use of the collections.addAll API. So that's it to this tutorial, and I will see you in another tutorial. Thanks for watching. Do like and subscribe.